This particular growth strategy, it encompasses a number of areas. Like it includes that it looks at some of the key strengths of the province, the remittances, the regional connectivity, the kind of urban agglomeration that we have. So in addition to that, it also looks at the inclusive part of it, where it talks about education, health, as well as skills development. And it also talks about the key development sectors of the province, like agriculture, services, manufacturing. So it is a very comprehensive document. There are various elements within that and various strategies that the province, or the plans that the province normally undertakes. But because we have traveled 3 years down the road, I believe it's always good to have a look, another look at the strategy. The broader features or the broader elements of it will remain the same, because these are the strengths of the province that have been there for many years. So those strengths will be there, those principal features will be there. But some more developments have taken place. Some private sector investments have come up. Some more investment has been made in health and education. Some more emphasis has been made on institutional building. Some international dynamics have changed the macro framework, economics framework at the federal level, or at the national level has changed also. So keeping in view all those elements, I think we always need to give it a review and add those new elements as part of the strategy.